Don't rely on the padlock. What the lock icon in your browser really means. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. For years, heck, decades even, we've been told to ensure that we're using an HTTPS connection when we connect to sensitive websites like our banks or our email providers. That provided a specific level of security that was particularly important and not always present. Today, it's ubiquitous. HTTPS is almost everywhere. As an interesting side effect of that, though, the significance of that little HTTPS lock icon, it's decreased dramatically. First, let's at least define what HTTPS is. HTTP is the protocol, or kind of like the computer conversational language, that's used for transferring web pages from the web server to your browser. Your browser and the web server have a little conversation in HTTP. HTTPS adds two things. One, data encryption, and two, identity confirmation. All right. By definition, HTTP is unencrypted. That means that anyone with the ability to monitor an HTTP conversation can see what it contains. That might include your ISP, someone within range of an open Wi-Fi hotspot you happen to be using, or the infrastructure of the entire internet anywhere between your computer and the website you're accessing. Before an HTTPS conversation starts, your computer and the remote website agree on an encryption key that is then used to encrypt or hide the contents of your conversation. Only your browser and the remote website can see what data you're exchanging, regardless of who might be listening in on the way. HTTPS also does what I refer to as identity confirmation. Before that conversation even begins, HTTPS confirms that the remote site is the site that it claims to be. Setting up HTTPS involves getting a digital certificate from a third party that is assigned to the specific website domain that a web server claims to be. For example, when you visit askleo.com using HTTPS, your browser first confirms that the digital certificate on the server it connects to is, in fact, the certificate for askleo.com. This protects your conversation from being intercepted and being redirected to, say, an imposter site. HTTPS actually confirms you're connected to the site you asked to connect to and not an imposter. All right, the padlock. The padlock icon is typically at the far right of your address bar, though actually fewer and fewer browsers are even bothering to display it anymore. It can indicate two things. One, that an HTTPS connection is in fact being used. And two, that the connection is or is not secure. Now, the mere presence of the icon or some variation of it tells you that the HTTPS protocol is being used. At a minimum, this probably means your data is being encrypted between your browser and the remote website. While encryption is good, though, it's not really enough to truly consider the connection secure. The icon can show normally, or it can show in some broken form. When the normal icon is displayed, then everything's fine. Your connection is encrypted, and the site you're connecting to is the site it claims to be. When the icon has a line through it, or is displayed in red, or is replaced by not secure, or some other change, this means, yep, something's up. The primary reason this happens include, well, the certificate used by the website has expired. Honestly, this is probably the most common thing you'll encounter, and yes, I've done it myself. Two, the certificate is from an unofficial or unrecognized authority, and thus the identity of the site cannot be confirmed to match what it is you asked for. Or, finally, the certificate indicates that it's for a website that is different than the website you're asking for. Now, at face value, when you get this error, it means you can't trust the website you're trying to connect to. In practice, it's not uncommon if you know what to look for to use additional information to confirm whether the error is truly significant. For example, we often ignore the error about a certificate having expired if that expiration is, say, less than a day or so ago. Like I said, webmasters, including myself, occasionally forget to renew. Now, there's something critical. The icon does not tell you something that I think a lot of people think it does. I chose my words very carefully. HTTPS also confirms that the remote site is the site it claims to be. This is not the same as HTTPS confirms that the remote site is the site you think it is. HTTPS does not do this. For example, it is very possible for www.ebay.com and www.ebay.com.someRandomService.com both to have valid HTTPS certificates and show a normal HTTPS lock icon. The first one, ebay.com, it's legitimate. It's what you expect. The second one, on the other hand, might be a scammer trying to fool you. And the status of HTTPS for that connection will not tell you that anything is wrong. Why? HTTPS is everywhere. Originally, HTTPS certificates cost money. This acted as both a barrier to entry and added a level of accountability. In an effort to improve privacy and some of the other aspects of online security, HTTPS certificates can now be acquired for free. This is great for website owners such as myself with several websites who would otherwise have to choose between that privacy and security versus that ongoing cost of a certificate for each site. But now anyone can easily set up HTTPS for their websites for free. And anyone, of course, includes scammers. With most websites now using HTTPS, its significance has faded, and many browsers don't bother to even show the padlock, unless there's a problem. So, remember this. The HTTPS padlock indicates a connection is secure, but it does not mean the website you're connecting to is secure or trustworthy. That's a completely different discussion. And do pay attention if the padlock or browser indicates that there's a problem with the connection. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/18181818. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.